Hello, my dear student, for the fourth semester ENE. Today we are start from the module 5 and they are having a topic page lock loop, that is a PLL, and they are having a the different section in there. One is the first one is the basic PLL system. In the basic PLL system we are discussing about the block diagram and operating principle, and the second one is PLL is component. The PLL component, in their component, the major is three component. The one is page detector, second is the low pass filter, and third one is voltage control oscillator. And after that, the last is the PLL performance factor. In the PLL performance of the page lock loop, the first one is loop gain of the PLL, and the second one is tracking range or locked range, and last one is the capture range of the in this slide we are discussing about the phase lock loop, that is the PLL, and the PLL circuit is a synchronizing output signal and generating by oscillator with the reference or input signal in the frequency as well as in a phase. The same PLL also, the self correcting circuit, it can be lock on to input frequency and adjust the track change in the input. Okay, next we are discussing about the block diagram and operating principle. In the here, the block diagram is given in here. In the block diagram, here is the input frequency, and is the first block is the phase detector. Output of the phase detector is connected to the low pass filter, and low pass filter output is connected to the voltage control oscillator, and it is the output of the frequency, and it is feedback path is connected to between the phase detector also. And here in the phase detector, means the phase detector is basically like a comparator, basically is a comparator, and that compare input frequency, that is F in, that is the F in, with the feedback frequency F out. And this comparison input frequency and output frequency, it provide a error signal, that is E, that is the error signal that is coming on the output of the phase detector. Error signal basically in the form of DC voltage, and this loop is locked. These two signals are same frequency, then it is phase difference is fixed phase difference will be there. And basically the phase detector work as XOR gate also. And second one is low pass filter. In the low pass filter is used to remove the high frequency component and noise also, and output of the phase detector. And the low pass filter is provide the steady DC level voltage, which is become a input of the VCO. And the last one is the voltage control oscillator. It voltage control oscillator to generate the frequency controlled by input voltage, and the DC level output of the low pass filter is applied to the control signal to the VCO, and this VCO adjusted till it become equal to frequency of the input signal. The VCO frequency is adjusted till it become equal to frequency of the input signal, and during this adjustment of the VCO, the PLL goes through three stages. That is, the first one is free running, and the second one is capture, and the third one is again the stage of PLL operation. The page lock loop goes through three state. The first one is free running, second one is capture, and third one is page lock. The free running stage, when no input is applied at the phase detector due to the VCO, then PL work as a free running stage. then output frequency of this stage depending on the free running frequency of VCO. And second one is the capture stage. When input frequency is applied at a phase detector, then due to feedback mechanism, the PLL try to track the output with respect to input. This stage is called as capture stage. Then last one is phase lock state. Due to the feedback mechanism, the frequency comparison stop as soon as output frequency become equal to input frequency. This stage also called as phase lock state. After this phase lock loop operation, next I will discussion about the application. The most commonly application in the first one is the demodulated frequency modulated signal, and in the radio transmitter also. In their radio transmitter, PLL used as in a new frequency which is multiple of the reference frequency. And next one, last one is the demodulation of the both frequency modulation and amplitude modulation. In this slide, we are discussing the PLL component. In the PLL component, three component. The major one is the phase detector, second is the low pass filter, and third one is voltage control oscillator. The first will start this phase detector. The phase detector is compare the input frequency and VCO frequency, and it generates the DC voltage. And this that is proportional to the phase difference between the two frequency. It is depending on the whether it is analog or digital phase detector used. And here one of this example I used in the digital phase detector. Only first one I use for exclusive OR phase detector, XOR gate detector. And here in the figure number A, and it is B, and it is C, and use the XOR gate. The output of the XOR gate is high only when FIN and FOUT is high. Though any one of the frequency is high, then output of the XOR gate is high. And here also where figure also is shown, this FIN is high, the FIN is high, starting of the FIN is high and FOUT is low, then output of the XOR gate is also high. After that FIN and FOUT is both are high, then output of the XOR gate is also low. Okay. And this the DC output voltage of XOR gate is phase detector is a function, the phase difference between the two outputs. And this is the maximum DC output is occur when phase difference is between the 0 to pi. The phase difference is 0 to pi, because here 0 to pi, and this the difference, the phase difference between 0 to pi, this is maximum, the slope of this curve above this, this is the slope of this curve 0 to pi, and this is 0 to pi, and this is the conversion gain of Kp of the phase detector. If XOR gate supply voltage is 5 volt, the conversion of Kp is equal to pi divided by pi, that is equal to 1.59 volt per radian. And this is exclusive OR type of phase detector. Generally you are using in frequency FIN and FOUT are in a square wave waveform. The PLL component of the second one, low pass filter. In the low pass filter used in the PLL lock is to get rid of the high frequency component in the output of the phase detector. And as shown in the two figure, we are given in the loop filter, and the second is the low pass filter. The loop filter we are using op amp with resistor component. And here only the component of the resistor and capacitor. And this low pass filter is also the remove the high frequency noise also, and all these feature in the low pass filter is a critical part of PLL and help the control dynamic characteristics of the whole circuit, the dynamic characteristics of the whole circuit. And the dynamic characteristics include in the capture and lock range and the bandwidth and the transient response. In the dynamic characteristics of this whole circuit, in their lock range is a tracking range, where the range of the frequency PLL system is follow the change in the input frequency, follow the change in the input frequency, and the capture range is a range which is a phase locker loop attain the phase lock, to attain the phase lock. When the filter bandwidth is reduced, the response time is increasing, but to reduce the capture range, but it is also help to reduce the noise, and it is maintain the locked loop through momentary loss of the signal. The two type of passive filter used in the low pass filter in the PLL. And an amplifier also used in the low pass filter also to obtain the in this slide the PLL component of the third voltage control oscillator. The main function of voltage control oscillator is to generate the output frequency that is directly proportional to input voltage. That is the basic block diagram of AC and NE 5-6 VCO I shown in the below figure, and this is the control voltage VC and output frequency of the VC. The maximum frequency of VCO is 500 kHz, and for the PLL system the VCO should be designed to oscillate at the selected pre-running frequency when control voltage is zero, and to increase or decrease its output frequency when control voltage is changed. The VCO sensitivity is the ratio of output frequency change to change in control voltage, that is K0 equal to delta F0 divided by delta V. And from the above figure, we have to show that running oscillator at its normal or pre-running frequency at nominal control voltage, that is VC, as shown in the figure here. The VC is minimum and F0 minimum, and VC nominal, then F0 also nominal. VC is maximum, F0 is maximum. It is shown in the figure, it is linearly increasing. Therefore, the frequency is also increasing with increasing the control voltage and above nominal value. The frequency decrease with the control voltage below the nominal voltage. In this slide, we are discussing about the PLL performance factor, that is the first one, loop gain. The loop gain of the PLL system, the gain from phase detector input terminal through the phase detector VD, comma filter VE, amplifier VA and VCO V0 back to the phase detector feedback terminal as shown in the figure, and here phase detector and filter, then amplifier, then output of the amplifier is connected to VCO and it is come to back. Now input to the system is the phase difference between the VI and V0, and output is VCO frequency is changed. Output is VCO frequency is changed from the loop gain can be calculated, that is AL equal to KD into AV into K0, where KD is the constant in volt per radian then AV is amplifier gain, the K naught is equal to constant, it is in the KS, K into hertz per volt, then AL is equal to express in terms of K into H divided by RD. This is the next. If VCO pre-running frequency is exactly equal to input frequency at the time of phase difference is 90 degree, means that is input frequency is equal to pre-running frequency. If input frequency is greater than pre-running frequency, then output frequency must be changed, means delta F naught is equal to input frequency minus pre-running frequency, that is equal to F, delta F naught equal to Fi minus FFR. The phase difference must be increasing positive or negative to produce the change in the F naught. Therefore, the delta phi is equal to delta F naught divided by AL. This is the phase difference must be positive or increasing the change in the delta F naught. This is the static error voltage is produced by this phase detector and amplifier applied to the VCO to keep it operating at the desired frequency. Because here the loop gain of PLF system is phase detector given by multiply by the amplifier gain and gain of the VCO. Because this input phase difference and the output frequency, that is gain unity are in kilohertz per radian. This is the continuum for PLL performance. This is second one is the lock range or tracking range. And when the frequency of the input to the PLL is changed, then output frequency change to track the input frequency. For each PLL, there is the upper and lower frequency limit. Beyond the output frequency will not to track the input frequency. The range of the frequency between the limit is known as tracking range, and or also called as lock range, or also called as hold range. When input frequencies goes the outside, because outside the tracking range, then output cannot be found, and result in the phase detector input has different frequency. The limit of the tracking range also larger set by the maximum voltage plus or minus VA. If it is the plus V and minus VA produced by phase detector, after this coming the filter, then amplifier. And this is VA is the output of the filter or output of the VA amplifier. Again, the VA is maybe positive, means VA is maximum. That is, we can track this maximum is tracking range, that is FT maximum. And when it is below, means it is minus negative, it is VA is the minimum, that is the tracking range is minimum. Therefore, the tracking range can be determined that FTR equal to plus or minus AL into delta pi, where delta pi is the change of phase difference between the input to the output. Because the maximum phase angle changing is minus pi by plus or minus pi by 2. Because change in phase, because already last previous slide we are discussing about the pi by 2, the range limit the conversion the gain of between the k naught equal to 0 to pi, but it is the half of that, means pi by 2. That FTR is a maximum plus or minus AL into pi by 2. The maximum minimum tracking range can be calculated. FTR maximum is FFR plus FTR. That is FFR means the pre-running frequency plus tracking range frequency. And this is same maximum. And when FTR is minimum, that is the pre-running frequency minus the tracking range frequency, that is FFR minus FFR. And this figure is shown that tracking PL is loop It is the maximum phase difference which produces the error voltage between the phase. In this slide, this is the third one, PLL performance factor, that is the capture range. The maximum range of the frequency within the PLL is attained the log is called as capture range and also called as acquisition range. When there is no input applied to the phase detector of the PLL system, the VCO oscillates at its pre-running frequency. If the input frequency is equal to the maximum tracking frequency, that is phase log should be offered. So for discussion for the tracking range, the previous slide, the error voltage must be maximum move VCO from pre-running frequency FFR to the maximum tracking frequency that is FT maximum. But VE output voltage is from the phase detector and it is proportional to average phase difference input and fed back to the waveform. That is the maximum input frequency at which phase is locked occur. The term is called as maximum capture range when the phase difference is input and output is constantly changed. Therefore, the capture range is given by FCR equal to plus or minus AL into delta pi, where AL is loop gain and delta pi is change of the phase difference of the phase detector. Then above the reason can be applied to the so that phase lock is will not occur with input frequency. It is equal to minimum tracking frequency. Therefore, I shown in this figure also. Here, this is the when it is minimum. It is a minimum tracking frequency means when it is frequencies. It is VA is minimum. The average is minus minimum. That is the minimum capture range. And when it is the average voltage is maximum capture range. That is the maximum range. And therefore, the maximum and minimum capture range also calculate FC maximum equal to FFR plus FCR, where FFR is the pre-running frequency, FCR is the capture range frequency. So FC minimum is equal to FFR minus FCR, where FFR is pre-running frequency minus capture range frequency. And this figure, in the show, this capture range is always less than the tracking range because this is the last border. This is the tracking range is because always less than the capture range, and average input voltage is always less than the maximum both input and output phase lock.